a little bit funny. This feeling inside, I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no.
We're just gonna do a sit down video, but we just sit down and sort of, I guess, update you guys on the baby, because we've not done that since before Christmas, and we thought it's a good time now that we've only got 6 weeks left.
Yeah, currently as we're sitting here, I am 34 weeks pregnant. And she is growing.
I should hope she's growing. It'd be pretty worrying if she weren't.
I would show you, but I can't.
I mean, you've seen her in previous videos. She made a great appearance in the last video. And she'll probably make appearances in future videos. But she's healthy, which is good.
Yeah, she's a little big than she should be.
With a smaller head than she should have.
Yeah.
So very misproportionate at this particular moment.
The placenta hadn't moved. Because I think we told you in the last video. Oh, sorry. I think we told you in the last video that the placenta was really low, and so they're saying that if it hasn't moved by my next scan, which is literally
in about 2 weeks,
as it's just said, then it's looking like I'm going to have a cesarean, because obviously they can't risk me going into labour and the placenta coming first, because that's really bad.
Yeah. So hopefully it doesn't come to that. I know it's the last thing either of us want is a cesarean.
Yeah.
But if it has to happen, then it has to happen, and you know, we've been preparing for the worst the whole time, haven't we?
Yeah.
And so far, it's all been so good. All we can do at this point is just hope that the placenta moves.
And because of my pelvis being as bad as it is, I am literally unable to walk. Like, I physically cannot walk. Not even from this spot to the door, which you can see. The dressing gown's on the door. I literally cannot walk that distance by myself. I am in a wheelchair, and I will be in a wheelchair for the rest of my pregnancy, which is what I've been told by many professionals. So that's not good, but it's also not good for Alex either, because he's the one that has to push it. I can't seem to push it properly. I can't seem to master being in a wheelchair, and my finger is injured because of my mishaps with the wheelchair. So
yeah, it's all on me. Which I don't mind, because it does mean we can get places a bit quicker than if Jenny was trying to wheel it along herself. I mean, it's great when she tries to wheel it along herself, because it gives me a break. But because obviously where we live,
there's so many hills.
There's so many hills. There's slopes, the roads are like, well, the footpaths are like that for a lot of it. So obviously if Gennie tries to steer herself, she ends up going like towards the road a little bit. So it, in the long run, it's just better for me to push her in the wheelchair.
It's a very slow process. It's a very slow process if I try to do it myself. So that is why Alex has to do most of it. Mm. And I am not good with being in a wheelchair because I feel very embarrassed. I feel like I shouldn't be in a wheelchair because, I mean, I can walk. I mean, it's very hard and I can't walk by myself, but I can still do it. It's just a lot slower and a lot harder. So I don't feel like, and obviously I don't have a disability that prevents me from walking, so I just feel like a bit of a div being in the wheelchair. And I also feel bad because it just leaves it all to Alex then.
The hardest thing is coming up the hill to our flat, because not only is the hill kind of a little bit steep, the wheelchair's heavy.
And I'm even heavier.
And where Gennie's got all the weight from being pregnant with the baby.
You can be honest, I'm pretty heavy.
Yeah, but the baby adds extra weight as well.
Yeah, I know.
Which obviously makes it
4 pounds worth.
Which makes it even harder to push Gennie up the hill. So it's definitely a workout, but at least I'll have massive legs by the end of it.
By the end of the 6 weeks, yeah.
By the time Jenny's out of the wheelchair, my legs will be hench. Skinny body, really thick legs. But
and also,
at least running will be easy.
It doesn't look like I'm going to be able to walk normally after the baby's born either, because obviously the cesarean and stuff, so it doesn't look like I'm going to be like snap and straight back to it doesn't look like I'm going to be straight back to pre-pregnancy Gennie. That's exciting.
But yeah, outside of Gennie being in the wheelchair, everything else is sweet with the baby. The baby's healthy. Baby can't get enough.
Yeah, the baby's absolutely fine.
It's just Gennie. Because you guys have pretty much seen the development of what's been happening throughout the pregnancy, because the whole time we've been, or Jenny's been pregnant, we've been filming it.
Yeah.
So if it's not been Jennie's pelvis, it was her knee, and before it was her knee, it was something else, and
yeah,
you know, one thing's just led to another, and over time it's got worse. So hopefully there is light at the end of this tunnel, because it's a very long tunnel.
Pregnancy is genuinely really long. It's very long-winded anyway. I mean, he's gonna say that it's not that long, which I would generally if it was somebody else going through it, but because I'm the one going through it, it does feel like I have been pregnant for about 2 years. It genuinely does.
The thing with this pregnancy is, it was the middle part for me that was the quickest, or seemed the quickest, because obviously by that point we were out of lockdown, I was going to work a lot, so I wasn't really thinking about how far along we were. And now that I'm not working and we're back in lockdown, every day it's like, how long have we got left? And as we count down towards the baby's due date, it seems a lot slower.
Yeah.
This last trimester has definitely been really slow and is dragged, and it feels like it's been longer than it has been. So I kind of get what you mean. But not really, because obviously I'm not the one carrying, but I still kind of get what you mean, because it's been really slow these last couple of months.
It's the endless pain that I'm in, continuously. As Alex has said, previously it was my knee. That was my own fault, because I fell on it. So that was my fault. But now it's my pelvis. And because of the extra weight that I'm carrying, my back starts playing up a little bit. I don't want to say that it's really bad, because it's not really bad. And I know people in worse situations than I'm in with their backs. But pregnancy just really does not help your back.
No.
Because you're carrying, like, you've got, like, two of you at the front. There's more, what am I trying to say? There's more weight at the front than there is at the back, which is then making the back sore, because...
Yeah. It's carrying all that extra weight.
Yeah. That's all I mean by that. I'm not complaining about my back or anything. Complaining about my pelvis, yeah, but... Because that's painful. And because of the placenta being so low, I mean, I'm not complaining about that, but that worries me beyond belief, because I don't want to have a cesarean. Mm-hmm. And they have said that I may have to, which terrifies me.
No one really wants a cesarean, though, do they?
No, no, but I really don't. I know they're probably going to put me out and stuff, but it's not really the point.
I know, you want to physically see the birth of your child.
I want to be in the room, yeah. And not, like, away with the fairies.
Well, that means...
Because, especially if you aren't allowed in there, I don't know if you're going to be allowed in there or not, and if you're not, then neither one of us are going to see our baby be born.
I know, which is going to be upsetting, don't get me wrong, because I've been waiting this whole time to see her be born. So I am praying more than anybody that the placenta moves its arse and, you know, shifts into gear and moves to where it needs to move to. But it's been an uphill struggle.
I think the phrase is downhill struggle.
No, it's uphill struggle. I'm pretty sure it's uphill struggle. Let us know in the comments. Alright, let us know in the comments. Is it uphill struggle or downhill struggle? Let us know. But I've always heard uphill struggle.
I've always had downhill struggle.
Why would you struggle going downhill?
Well, you don't generally, but because of the situations and things, it makes you go downhill, doesn't it? You as in, like, your mood-wise, it goes downhill.
Yeah.
And therefore it's a struggle, so downhill struggle.
Yeah, but I think it's referring to, like, if you're walking up a hill, like, it's... hard walking up the hill, but it's really easy walking down, and I think that's what it refers to. But let us know in the comments.
Not in a wheelchair, it's not.
No, not in a wheelchair. Just as difficult both ways. But let us know down in the comments which one you think it is. Is it uphill struggle or downhill struggle? Because apparently we've had two very different, you know, upbringings.
Oh, we have. I'm going to be honest. I was going to show you my little bump that I got, but... I'm not going to do that because I'm not wearing a bra, so I'm not, or trousers, so I'm not standing up.
I mean, you've seen the bump in previous videos, as we said near the beginning. And you'll obviously see her several more times, probably before she's born. Just because she's a massive, massive part of our lives. And
I thought you were going to say she's a massive, massive bump. I was going to go, gee, thanks. I didn't realise I was that big.
No, she's a massive part of our lives, and so you will see it. Like, you can kind of see her a little bit there.
See?
Sort of, yeah, you can somewhat see her. You can see her, you'd definitely be able to see her in the intro of this video anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah, you'll see her in future videos to come.
And obviously we'll show her off when she's here.
Yeah.
Which doesn't look like it's going to be as long as we thought it was originally. Which I am praying for, I don't pray because I don't believe, but I am praying for.
Right, Jenny's the one person who just wants this pregnancy to be over with, and I get it, because obviously all the pain and she's going through, and she has soldiered through it as best as she can, and I'm so proud of her. You know, I'm sorry that I've had to put you through all this just so I can be a dad.
That's alright.
But I'm thankful for everything that you've been through in this pregnancy, and I think helping you, like, move around the flat, and it's helped bring us closer a little bit, and brought us made us stronger as a couple, because if we can get through this, then we'll get through anything.
It's literally seeing me hurl my guts up, like projectile vomit all over the place, and he's still here, so he's stronger than I am, because I mean, I'm not saying I'd be gone.
That's your vomit, see you later.
Well, I'm not saying I'd be gone, but I would definitely be a bit more jumpy around him if it was the other way around, because I wouldn't want to see it again. But he has not only seen me projectile vomit all over the place, but cleaned it up for me when I was cleaning myself up.
Oh,
and yeah. Also, he's literally seen me piss myself. He's still here, so which is because of my bladder, by the way. Just
well, I mean, I've seen too many gory films to, you know, for not a lot to really freak me out. There's not a lot that does freak me out when it comes to things like that. So I don't mind stuff like that. And I know it's not easy for anybody because it still stinks. Mm. And it's not easy to clean up. And it's obviously not easy for anyone to go through something like that. But I don't mind because obviously the payoff after all of this is going to be worth it. And I love her, so yeah, that's worth it in itself.
I was also going to say, to do with the pregnancy, I've been a bit of an emotional wreck. Like, literal train wreck. Because, like, I'll be absolutely fine watching telly, being the happiest mood going, and then, like, an advert will come on. Will come. You know the cleft lip advert that's on telly at the moment? Every time that comes on, I'm just sat there crying over it for literally no reason. And everyone thinks it's for another reason. It's not. It's just because of an advert.
Isn't it a pregnancy thing, though? Because obviously, yeah, that you get a bit more emotional, a bit more hormonal, and that all comes into effect when you're pregnant. I don't know the ins and outs of it, obviously, but that's
pregnancy does make you hormonal, doesn't it? But I was just touching on the fact that I haven't been the easiest to live with by any means. I've been really difficult to live with, and for the fact that I can't do a lot, also by myself, makes me even harder to live with, because I want to do stuff by myself and then I end up crying because I can't do stuff by myself. So everything just takes so much longer than it normally would.
Yeah, but you do those things like that for the ones you love, don't you? Because you just can't... And I've got a caring nature anyway. So it's really difficult for me to not care when somebody that I care about, someone I love, is going through something like that, because it's really hard for me not to care, as you've probably seen.
Yeah.
So I'm just naturally like that.
Sorry if I keep looking down, by the way, it's just because I'm looking at my finger.
have we mentioned everything?
Other than my broken finger, no.
I mean, we touched on the broken finger before. We don't need to go into it again.
But that also makes things harder, because I can't pick things up and I can't carry things as well as I was able to. I can't hold things as much as I was able to. Sorry for the sit down video.
But yeah. Anyway, if you did like this video, thumbs up. Subscribe. Turn on the bell so you never miss an upload. All of our social media links are in the description, including Gennie's solo YouTube channel and both of my solo YouTube channels, because I'm going to bring back one of my... If you didn't see the last video, I'm bringing back one of my old channels. That's it from us. See you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.